Hello friends, today we are going to see a very rich and traditional healthy item, moringa leaves ragi adai. This is moringa leaves. It is very rich in iron and other vitamins. We are going to use this in ragi adai today. Let us see how to remove the leaves. We have to remove the leaves in reverse direction. In other spinach, we will remove in directly. Here we have to remove in reverse direction. Then take the small one and again remove in reverse direction. Now take 2 cups of ragi flour. I have taken 2 cups of ragi flour, a little Himalayan salt. Now I am going to saute the moringa leaves along with onion and green chili. In a pan, add 2 teaspoons of gingerly oil or ghee or any cooking oil. Add mustard seeds, urad dal. When it splatters, add green chili and finely chopped onion. Saute it well till the onions are transparent. After the onions are transparent, now add the washed moringa leaves. You can add lot of moringa leaves because after it is sauteed, it will become very less. So add the washed fresh moringa leaves and a little salt with it. Saute it nicely. There is a proverb in Tamil, "Vendu kettadu murungai." So you should not cook the moringa leaves for a long time. Saute it for a few minutes and then add it to the ragi flour. I'm going to add it to the ragi flour. Transfer all the onions and moringa leaves to the ragi flour. Now we are going to make the dough like chapati dough. I'm adding a little bit of chili powder and 2 tablespoons of curd, fresh homemade curd, or you can use sour curd also. Mix the flour well, sprinkle some water if you need and make it as a chapati dough. The dough is ready now. Now make big lemon size or sweet lime size balls out of this flour. For 2 cups of flour, I got 6 ragi balls. If we make even sized balls and keep it aside, it will be easy for us to make the ragi adai. Now I got 6 balls out of 2 cups of flour. Now heat a iron dosa tawa, or if you don't have, you can eat non-stick also. If it is a heavy bottom tawa, it will be good. I am using a non-electric chapati presser to make the ragi adai. You can even make it with a hand. Place a plastic sheet over the non-electric chapati presser, grease it with oil and keep a ball inside and press it. You will get a evenly spread ragi adai. Spread the corners with fingers nicely. You can press the whole adai nicely with your fingers. Then we have to transfer it to the tawa directly. You can even use banana leaf. I have transferred the ragi adai to the hot pan. Keep the heat in medium flame. Sprinkle some ghee or oil of your choice. Cook in medium flame nicely. Ragi will take some time to cook, so flip it over again and cook nicely. If you want, you can put a hole in the center so that it gets cooked evenly and nicely. Spread gingerly oil, coconut oil or ghee or any cooking oil lightly. Ragi will split the oil at once, so you won't be needing lot of oil to make ragi adai. Just a few drops is enough. If we use ghee, the flavor will be very nice, and ghee is good for health also. So flip it over and cook the ragi adai nicely. The indication is the color will turn into dark brown or little black color. That is the indication that the ragi is cooked well. Now transfer it to a plate. Nice ragi adais are ready. You can have it with curd and pickle of your choice, or vatta kolambu also. Ragi will make us feel thirsty, so using curd along with it is a very nice combination. Do it and enjoy, friends. Please send your feedback too. If you like this video, please like it, subscribe and share it to your friends also. See how well it is cooked.